Hi, welcome back. I'm Rakesh Naik. Today we are going to discuss about an application of greedy method, that is Knapsack problem. Before we start, a small request. If you are watching a video for the first time in this channel, kindly press the subscribe button and then the bell icon so that you will get all the notifications from this channel. So without wasting any more time, let's start. In the knapsack problem, items are given, along with that a knapsack is given, and each of them having some kind of capacity. As here, the capacity of knapsack is 9 kg and the item A weights 5 kg and you can earn a profit of 30 rupees. Item B weights 3 kg and you can earn an item of 50 rupees. Item C weights 6 kg and you can earn a profit of 10 rupees, and item D weights 1 kg and you can earn an item of 80 rupees. Now the question is, how that you can take the item into the bag so that you will get maximum profit? So if we'll try a heat and trial method, you can take only item A, it will be only having, you can get a total profit of 30. If you are taking only item B, the weight is 3 and you can get a total profit of 50. Similarly, you are taking, if you are choosing only item A and B, the total weight will be 8. So like that, if you can go, you will be having many options. But out of which, if you are taking A, B and D, that is the total weight is 9 and the maximum profit you will get 160. This is what a knapsack problem is. But here we are going to apply greedy method to find the solution of this knapsack problem. So let us try to find the objective once more. The objective is, we are having an objects, let us say x1, x2, xn, and each of them having a respective weight like w1, w2 and wm, and having respective profit also, p1, p2, pn. It means item x1 is having weight w1 and you can get a profit of p1, and the capacity of the knapsack is w. It means if you choose the object I, it will weigh to wi that you can place in the knapsack and you can get a profit of pi, and the objective is to maximize your profit. When we apply greedy technique to solve this problem, choose only those objects which give me maximum profit. If I want to write it mathematically, what I have to do? Summation of pi xi, I have to maximize with a constraint that summation of wi xi should be less than or equal to the size of the knapsack. Here, of course, I can take the fraction of a particular item. Now we'll try to understand this problem with the help of an example. Let us say n, it is the number of items given. A w is the size or the weight of the knapsack. And P1, P2, P3 are the profits that you can earn from 3 items. And W1, W2, W3 are the respective weight of these items. Then what we can do? We can write this data in a tabular form. Like first item, the profit is 25 and the weight is 18. Second item, profit is 24, weight is 15. Third item, profit is 15 and weight is 10. Let us say these are my feasible solution. It means if x1, x2, x3 are the item, then I can take fully x1, 2 by 15 of x2 and 0 of x3. If I am choosing the first item fully, it means weight 18 is selected. Only 2 are left out because the weight of the knapsack is 20. So 2 by 15 weight I can take off x2 item, and 0 I can take off x3 item. In the second case, I am choosing fully item 3. It means out of 20, 10 I have devoted for item 3. And rest of the item, that is another 10 item, I can take from x2. That is 2 by 3 of x2 I can take, and 0 of item 3 I can take. Similarly, in the third case, I can take x2 fully, that is 15. Remaining 5 I can take from the third item. The total weight is 10, so half of 10 is 5, so 15 plus 5 is 20 I can fill my knapsack. Now basically, what are the basic ways of finding this thing? So we need to find the maximum profit per unit weight. P1 W1 is 25 by 18, that is 1.4. P2 W2 is 24 by 15, that is 1.6, and P3W3 is 15 by 10, that is 1.5. Now out of these three, here 1.6 is maximum. So the profit per weight I can get maximum when I choose the second item. It means I'll choose the second item fully, so that weight of 15 is added to the knapsack. Weight, total weight is 20. So 20 minus 15, another 5 items of either item 1 or item 3 I can put. So out of these 3, next highest number is 1.5. So this is the next maximum. So I can take 5 unit of X3. It means the total weight available to me is 10 of the third item. So half of it I'll take. That's how I'm choosing my third case, that is X1 to be 0, X2 to be 1 and X3 to be half. Now let us find summation of Wi and Xi. So in the case 1, what I'm having? I'm choosing full amount of X1. So 1 into 18. Then I'm choosing 2 by 15 of X2. So 2 by 15 of 15. And the 0 of X3, so 0 into 10. So the summation of Wi Xi in the first case, it becomes 20. Now take second case. So 0, 2 by 3 and 1. So 0 amount into 18, 2 by 3 into 15 and 1 into 10. So I am getting again 20. In the third case, 0, 1 and 0.5. So 0 into 18, 1 into 15 and half into 10. Here also I am getting 20. In all the cases, the maximum weight that I can achieve is 20. So the constant, that summation of Wi Xi, should be less than or equal to the weight of the knapsack. So in the all the three cases, it is satisfied. Now let us see about the profit. So summation of Pi Xi we need to find. The case 1, full amount of X1 I am taking and I am getting a profit of 25 when I am choosing X1. So 25 into 1. Next, I am getting a profit of 24 for item 2 and I am choosing 2 by 15 of item 2. So 24 into 2 by 15. And for the third item, the profit is 15. So 15 into 0, that is 28.2. In the second case, the profit is 25 into the item is 0, so 25 into 0. Second item's profit is 25 and I'm choosing 2/3 of it, so 24 into 3. And for the third item, it is 15, the profit is 15 and I'm choosing full amount of the third item, so 15 into 1. So I'm getting a profit of 31. In the third case, you can see first item of profit is 25, but I am choosing 0, so 25 into 0. Second item's profit is 24 but I am choosing it fully, so 24 into 1. And third item's profit is 15 and I am choosing half of it, so 15 into half, that is 31.5. so if I want to tabularize it, summation of Wi Xi and summation of Pi Xi, so I can see the third case is giving me the maximum profit. So let us see the algorithm. Algorithm greedy, knapsack W and N. So what we are assuming, before starting the algorithm, we are assuming that we have already profit per weight ratio, I have already kept in a decreasing order, where Pi is the profit, Wi is the weight and Xi is the solution vector of ith item. And Wi is the size of the knapsack and N is the item. So for I equal to 1 to N, if weight of the ith item is less than the weight of the knapsack, then I'll write Xi to be 1. And I'll reduce the size of the knapsack by the weight of the item. And if I is less than equal to N, then what I have to do? Xi equal to size of the knapsack by Wi. So this will give me the solution of greedy knapsack problem. So as there is only one for loop, we can say that complexity will be theta of n. Thank you for watching this video till the end. Keep watching, keep learning, and if you like the video, It requires a thumbs up. Please give me a thumbs up and share with your friends. Thank you. Thank you.